suddenly Gibraltar became one of the most important places in chess world because of traditional chess festival.
Most chess events or senior chess events like this one are a chess tournament. We call ourselves a festival, and that means that we can do many things around the periphery.
The Gibraltar International Chess Festival is a seminar where participants can move with and learn from the best. Taking place here at the university, it's a prelude to the games themselves.
The advantage White has is much, much bigger if you trade the rooks, in most of the cases. So this is like a loss of bishop. Okay, it could be a knight or bishop.
The seminar is very interesting for me because I've put a lot of thought into there's a question of adult improvement. Can you improve at chess as an adult, and can you improve by much? And I'm really hoping that I can up my skills through the seminar.
Can you improve as an adult?
Well, that's an open question, and some people say it's very hard to improve as an adult because you're fixed and your brain patterns are all fixed in stone once you reach a certain fairly young age. So I'm just hoping that I can see my way through this, and I'm hoping that access to and exposure to a couple of very strong players. What I'm really looking for is different thought patterns and different ways that they go about it, which might be what's holding me back.
This, two rooks against rook and knight, no? So, okay, it's exchange up. But the advantage White has is much, much bigger if you trade the rooks.
And for someone like yourself who's been at the very top, what does chess mean to you?
Well, it's a combination of many things. I would say that long term it will become as a part of the culture, mainly in Europe. It will be part of the history of Europe, and it will be part of the European culture. Obviously, it's not a real sport, but it is a competition, and it is a good educational tool. And also it has a scientific part, because we have to really remember and discover many things. But what I really liked about chess is that the creative part, because before you play, you prepare and you try to find some new ideas. So it has very nice creative part. This is mostly what I like. But again, I think from 100 years from now, it will be still part of the history of the world, of the cultural history, and it will be a good educational tool for
kids. Do you
kids.
Play at home?
I'm trying to for the moment, without any success, to teach my daughter to play. But for the moment, she's six, and I'm a complete disaster in teaching her.
My king was on stalemate. I already have spotted there is a chance, and when in the moment like my opponent was to move, I said like he would probably not play rook f4. I can't be that lucky, but he did.
But I mean, the percentage of Muyan in chess increased significantly, because I remember before we reached 2000, I think the percentage was like 7%. In registered women players, and now I think we raised up to 15 nearly. So
when you have fewer women playing, which means that you have more men champions. So do you think that eventually will catch up?
Well, I mean, eventually, well, this is difficult because, okay, nowadays we have one woman. Okay, if Judith Polgar, if you don't count her, because if she would get back to chess, we would have two women in the top 100. Because for men or for boys, they have the ability, if they are like addicted to something or like crazy about something, then they would stick to it for hours and hours. And then the character of a woman or of a girl, I think this is just not given, because we are like, maybe even by evolution, we are used to do a lot of things, like we did the birth giving, we did the care, we took care, care of the child, we were cooking, we were cleaning, we did, I mean, from the evolutionary point of view, and the guys, they were hunting, and sometimes they were like hunting, staying still for 4 hours to then get the reward of shooting an animal. So I think it's already like by the evolutional point of view that the character of a man is more suitable to concentrate or to focus on just one thing, and in the evolutional point of view from the woman, it's not possible. I mean, it's possible, but it's less likely.
Yes.
And the feminists would say it's just because we don't get the same condition, which is also in some way true, because if I compare my support in my country, chess-wise, compared to now we have a boy's talent and he gets supported much better, I could also say like it's partly also because we don't have the same support.
So either the king or the queen's pawn moves two squares.
Okay.
It's very important, the center of the chessboard at the start of the game. Later on, the edges might be important. But so things on the edge, it's like this, like no top player would start a game like that. You know, the object of chess is to win the other person's king, trap the other person's king.
Okay.
That's the object of the game. So to win a game of chess, you have to checkmate the king.
But once you do the queen, you're like halfway there, no?
Well, queen is the second most valuable piece, yeah. You can win a game of chess in two moves.
How?
Well, I'll show you. So if white were to start with pawn there, which is not the best, and black moves her pawn, and then black, this is a really awful move. I know you don't know how the rules of the game, but the queens move diagonally or on straight lines, all right? So this queen can move down here.
Oh.
Now black can win in one move. So black moves her queen, this queen, from this square to this square. Check, and this king is now
dead.
So the king is attacked by the queen, the black queen. The king cannot escape. It's blocked by its own pieces, and there's nothing that can be put in the way to block. If you could block the check, it would be all right, but there's nothing, you can't stop this next move. So this king is dead.
How does this one move?
Diagonally.
And this one?
The knight could come here. It's two in one, like an L shape. And the bishops move like this. So there's nothing that can go on those two squares.
Okay. Yeah.
So whatever white does, doesn't matter here or something, black takes the king and that's the game's over. So there's nothing can prevent the loss of the king, so that would be the end of the game. So the quickest game of chess possible is two moves each. There's two moves. But you won't see this game played at the Caleta Hotel, even by the lowest ranked players, you know?
How's it going? How is the tournament? How happy are you with the way it's developed?
Well, it's our 18th edition. I think it's a fantastic, it's a world famous event. People have come here from I don't know how many countries, at least 60. Some people have been here 12, 13 years in a row, others coming for the first time. There's a real buzz, there's a real special enthusiasm and passion for chess, and also making friendships and discovering Gibraltar, coming here, as I say, many people for the first time, bringing their families, bringing their kids, or the children are playing and the parents are here with the children.
When you talk to the participants, that seems to be what we have got totally right, that social aspect of it.
Very much so.
They do enjoy it.
I mean, I can tell you, I was a chess professional for 20, 25 years. Most, very few tournaments, if any, have the kind of things that we offer around the festival, the social program that we've built up over these years. Thank you.
Isn't it? Because it can be a bit intense otherwise.
Well, it can be. And also, well, chess players love playing chess. That's the reason they're here, is to play chess. But don't forget that chess can be played at home in your with a friend at home or on the internet as well. So why would somebody come from Argentina or India or Australia to Gibraltar to play chess when they could sit at home and play online?
And how does a tournament actually work? How do you ensure that nobody cheats? Who makes up the rules?
We have recognized arbiters, international chess arbiters, who are here to monitor the players, to monitor the tournament hall, to make sure that nothing untowards is taking place.
So the role of arbiter, either chief arbiter or the arbiter's team, is like the crew on an airplane. We need to bring the passengers, who are the players here, from a starting point to an ending point. We will be together with the players for 10 rounds. We decide who plays against whom, round after round, and we make sure during the game that everything goes smoothly in terms of comfort, light, playing conditions, and also, of course, making sure that the regulations are respected by the players. We have a team of 10 arbiters, approximately. Half of them work in the morning, half of them in the afternoon, because GibChess Festival is a group of many tournaments, so that amateurs, professionals, can all play chess together in Gibraltar. So we need a lot of people to take care of them.
This year you've got the president of FIDE actually coming to Gibraltar. Do we follow FIDE's rules and regulations?
We have to, we do indeed, we always have done. Yes, we come under the umbrella, if you will, of the World Chess Federation. And every game that is played in this festival is sent for rating purposes. So the chess players here have their own ranking, their ratings, and according to how they do, if they win or lose, obviously their ratings will go up or go down.
How important is that to the player, that they do get the ratings?
It's very important. I mean, you ask any of the players here, and the chess players are almost obsessed sometimes by their ratings and trying to get up to the next level. If you're 1,700, to get to 1,750 might be a really big deal, a real big thing, you know.
We're not actually members of FIDE though, are we?
We're not, because Gibraltar, I mean, nothing was done at the time. If we had applied, if Gibraltar had applied, I'm not sure when, but maybe in the 1970s, we would have been accepted, I believe. Now, on the current regulations, it's not possible, but there may be things happening in that direction. In fact, the visit of the FIDE president is very important part of that.
Ooh, so, watch this space.
Yeah, watch this space.
Gibraltar International Chess Festival is a great tradition. It's the 18th edition of the festival, and I can see that people love going here, and players love both the place and how the tournament is structured, and side events as well. Good mix of players, actually both top level and medium level, also lots of ladies who play both in the Masters and side events. Gibraltar is a great example of how to do that.
Yeah. Ironic though that the Gibraltar Festival is in a jurisdiction which is not a member of FIDE.
That's right, and unfortunately the Chess Association of Gibraltar was weak historically, but this tournament brought life to chess in Gibraltar, and now we are considering how to bring Gibraltar into chess family.
How many participants have you had this year?
We have about 250 in the Masters and another 150 or more in the morning events.
Does it count with a lot of local participation or at least local enthusiasm?
Absolutely, yeah. We have many local children taking part in the amateur sections and adults as well, and also in the Masters in the afternoon. So we have local representation.
And the spin-off is that it has had an effect on children learning chess on the rock.
Oh, no question it has, yeah, after all these years, yeah. And it's very important that local people can take part and do take part. Absolutely. Yeah. So it's growing and it's vibrant and it's of course there's football and there's dance and there's music and there's everything else that kids can do and should do. But chess is there. But chess is there as well.
There's chess.
Yes, absolutely. Why you so salty? I'll still take a bite. Okay, you can take my Lambo. I'll put on a tight show. You sure you can handle? We be faster than Django.
Welcome to Gibraltar. Can't stop, won't stop.
5-4.
He will be fighting for the title and the first prize of £30,000 tomorrow.
Okay. Hammonds has been involved with the Gibraltar International Chess Festival since the very beginning, since 2003, as we all know, the brainchild of Brian Callaghan. And gradually we've been doing more and more things in the audio-visual world and supporting the event in many, many aspects. This year we've taken it up a big step, and we're doing all the live streaming and the commentary. We also do all the side events, the Battle of the Sexes, which is a really, really good event where it sort of everybody relaxes and everybody has a great time. And it's a big, big thing and something very unique to the Gibraltar International Chess Festival.
Thank you.
obviously, when the festival started, we just started with a couple of screens around the hotel, relaying the live games. But that has evolved tremendously. We have a distribution network throughout the hotel. We've got the flexibility of showing all the games, of showing interviews, of showing the live commentary. And we started with very, very little equipment. Obviously, since 2003, like we all know, technology has evolved tremendously. And now we can do a lot more things than what we used to. The great thing with our streaming studio is a new system, which is NDI. It's a new protocol which allows us to relay information, screens, and everything throughout the hotel.